Frozen embryo transfer is now the most common and effective method for performing IVF. In order to be successful, the embryo must be placed into a uterus at a time when the lining is able to accept it and allow implantation. For many years, this has been accomplished by preparing the uterine lining with hormones, but other techniques have been evolving and gaining in popularity. What are these methods? Stay tuned. First, a little background. In order to become receptive to an embryo, the uterine lining must be prepared with two hormones. First, estrogen thickens the uterine lining. Second, progesterone transforms the lining to make it receptive to the embryo. Estrogen is produced from a developing follicle in the ovary. After ovulation, the follicle starts producing high levels of progesterone. The estrogen and progesterone circulate through the blood vessels to the uterus, where they prepare the uterus for a pregnancy every month. An easy and reliable way to prepare the uterus is by giving women these hormones. Estrogen is usually given orally with a pill. However, it can also be given vaginally, by a skin patch, or even by injection. Progesterone, because it is so important to the process, is often given by intramuscular injections or by a combination of injections and vaginal administration. Progesterone is not given orally for this purpose because it is broken down by the stomach. This method of preparing the uterus is often referred to as hormone replacement, or HRT. It has many advantages. It ensures adequate levels of the hormones are being given. Some women, such as those who are menopausal or don't ovulate, may be unable to produce these hormones on their own. Furthermore, HRT allows adjustment of the dose or methods of administration so we can individualize each patient's treatment and ensure that the timing of the transfer is precise. It also allows flexibility in the timing of the transfer to avoid weekends and holidays. What are some of the other methods for preparing the uterine lining? If a woman ovulates on her own, it is possible to perform what is called a natural cycle transfer. This method is a little trickier. It involves monitoring closely with blood tests, ultrasounds, and even urine tests. This extra monitoring is needed so that the exact time of ovulation is known. The embryo is transferred several days later. Natural cycles can be frustrating. Sometimes, despite all of the monitoring, ovulation may be missed. Or, based on the timing of ovulation, the transfer would end up occurring at an inconvenient or impossible time. Sometimes, ovulation might occur before the lining has had a chance to thicken adequately, for example. Because of these problems, some IVF centers will perform what is called a modified natural cycle. With this method, the patient is still monitored to assess the maturation of the egg in the ovaries, but once the uterine lining is thought to be ready, the patient will take a medication called HCG to trigger ovulation. This can help improve the scheduling of the embryo transfer. Afterwards, some modified protocols will also have the patient take progesterone to support the uterine lining. A natural or modified natural cycle can only be used if a woman is ovulating on her own. What if she doesn't ovulate on her own? HRT is commonly used for these women, but another option is to use fertility medications to induce ovulation. Some centers have used oral fertility medications such as Clomid or Letrozole. Others have used injections such as Follistim or Gonal-F. Some others may even use a combination of pills and injections. At this time, we have more studies and data regarding HRT for frozen embryo transfer. There just haven't been a lot of high-quality studies about the use of these other methods yet. But the data that we do have seems to suggest that these other methods may work just as well. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.